cover up a bunch of enemies. Start swinging for the fences. They damage just anything he touches. That's actually kind of lame. Like, there is some synergy on that with his tackle, but that's still not impressive. Said already, I really do like this about. I really do like that about this game. Upgrading other family members improves the rest of your family. It's not only a smart way to encourage you to get good at multiple characters, there's also a narrative reason behind it too, because they're meant to be working together.
Something more sinister would be appearing soon. A new challenger appeared.
wait on picking that up. Problems, swing your dick at me. Yeah. Ah, crap. Smite! While we're standing on one, then eventually we can get some treasure out of it. Increase his movement speed and damage. I pinch. Or a second trigger ability. Uses frenzy to perform whirlwind. Primary attacks build frenzy. Oh no, it's a frenzy mechanic. Okay. at him.
Grandma was already there, as always, before the Bergson could have a look around. Those who approach the light will gain more valuable experiences, was how the tablet was explained. The sun baked the captive,
nearly
worked to death with such little water.
I dodged that! Fine, whatever. I'll hold on to it now. I did get another ring. Increases the amount of XP from enemies. Hell yeah. Blood 2 levels into that. Progress with Martin's with Joey's levels. I partially want to take Kevin, but he is not going to survive against these types of enemies. Let's take Linda. Stopped using her. also doesn't help on this one is that when I was playing with Brony yesterday, I was pretty much exclusively using Linda. Part of it is that I just feel a little more at home with him at a distance. What do we have here? Karma attack is triplicate? Okay, so we have a means of dealing with the rats. I think if all three of those arrows hit, that's a lot of damage right then and there. Still not particularly great room. The circumstances in which you'd be hitting an enemy multiple times, or otherwise hitting multiple enemies at once with that type of arrow spread,
a momentary reprieve and a prize to pick up.
Hello? Hey lady, you looking stunning. Nice try. Just keep distance and you should be A-okay, mate. Movement speed and crit rate are increased. But honestly, Harmonic Slam, just so I can have a second ability, one. And two, it gives her more of a chance to actually build her increased damage. Slam deals damage. Ah, that's a crap rare. I want to get rid of it as soon as possible. Putting your main means of damaging enemies as something that harms you on use? No, no. That's anti-synergy for me. It could depend on the person, But I've never been a fan of any type of move that harms you when you use it. Period. I prefer to play safe. This isn't playing safe. Situations where firing that type of fan of arrows in a crowd will actually hit anywhere more than one target. And if you're within the effective range in which you're hitting two targets anyway, chances are you should be backing up. To this mastery wall you've got. Floor of the dungeon, I should say. Oh, love you. Awesome! Okay. Three damage. Spare health pot just in case I need it. Stunning enemies you come into contact with as you evade. Oh, excuse me? Like, stun doesn't last that long, but that's a lot more fractional than you think. Even to at least buy yourself time.
Something more sinister would be appearing soon.
Just keep moving, just keep moving. Corpse not, tired legs not coming. Attack gonna be using a rage at some point, so let's just sow the seeds of that.
A new challenger appeared.
Why does it keep saying that? It's because there's another elite. Oh, for the love of piss. Yes, I think it is. Gain stamina for every enemy hit. Great. So now in an emergency, I can pop it and keep moving if I've been moving for a while already. I keep getting so careless. Let's give Kevin a shot. We'll have this be a last run in the worst, in the best case, and the worst case. Actually, we'll have this be a last run in the worst case scenario. Best case scenario, we switch to another game. Because honestly, I'm still vaguely salty about the whole Root Factory shtick. And I don't like shortchanging people. Because, just saying, all that I've recorded in those 2 hours of Root Factory, I have maybe like 15, 20 minutes of the VOD to actually save and use, which I'm is crap. Practically unusable. Perform Guardian Fist. Nice. You push. I did get to experiment with this one finally, and it's kind of gross how effective it is. Like, the moment you hear a slowing effect, you think it's like a very small field. Look at this thing. This is huge. This effectively creates a denial of service area. Sorry. Stays in frenzy until he gets hit, I think? That's kinda gross. Gain Kevin's ability runes. Nice. Execute? Oh, I want that. That'll make it a lot more worthwhile to look. Area too. Let's see, this charm is... Shields are more effective, but... Heal less? No, that's kind of trash. Knives is condensed into a small cone. That just said instant kill? I mean, I've heard of normal amounts of kill, but insta kill? A giblet. Twist.
Steps were taken without regret, for it was never possible to change a destiny unknown.
So now cloaking is even better. Dodge that. Roach of Insanity greatly increases crit rate and damage at the cost of a slow constant drain. Oh, that's not great. This one. This one. Oh. And it's the end of the floor. I should have grabbed the cone. Oh well.